to church building somewhere, college church, please. Please tell others your experience with that church so they too can be saved and begin to hear from the Holy Spirit and begin to be guided by the Holy Spirit and begin to follow the plan of God. Please, wake up from your slumber. When you have awakened from the slumber, I am pleading with you. Please, don't start anything. Go in your closet. As God leads and guides you, tell others how God also taught you, so that they too will follow in the steps. So that by the time the Antichrist is coming, there's an army ready with God's truth. Because they're being guided each moment of their life by the Holy Spirit. He will be leading them. Because Christ is leading you. Which brings us to the song we have today. It's Christ that leads me. And I want him to lead you too. And as Christ is leading you, the Holy Spirit is the one that empowers and guides and teaches you. Praise the Lord. Jesus leads me. Oh, blessed thought. Oh, what sweet heavenly comfort fraught. Whatever I do, wherever I be, it's still God's hand that leadeth me. And that's what I'm saying to you today. Allow him to lead you. Allow him to lead you. Because he leads me. Next verse. He leadeth me by his own hand. He leadeth me. And his faithful follower, I will always be by his grace. For by his hand he leadeth me. That's what I want today for you to also ask the Lord Jesus Christ to lead you. So the Holy Spirit will teach according to guide you. Sometimes in the midst sense of deepest gloom, sometimes where intense flowers bloom, but waters come over troubled sea, meaning in whatever circumstance, it's still God's hand that leadeth me. He leadeth me. By his own hand, he leadeth me. And his faithful follower, I will forever be by his grace. For by his hand, he leadeth me. And that's why today I plead with you. Allow the Lord Jesus Christ to lead you. When you allow him to lead you, after you have surrendered your life to him, when you have done that, the Holy Spirit will teach you, he will guide you, and he will empower you. And if you have not been baptized in the Spirit, he will baptize you. Because the Lord Jesus Christ is the baptizer of the Holy Spirit. Take it from me. Years ago, I determined that only he, God, will teach me. And the Holy Spirit has been teaching me for so many years. All you have been hearing about this ministry and from this ministry are taught and enabled by him and not by any human being, me included. But don't take my word for it. Go in your closet and see these things are not so. When time you experience God speaking to you and guiding your life, no one can ever deceive you again. Shall we pray? In Jesus' name we pray. Our Father and our God, I thank you for you picked me from the gutters of life. And despite my wickedness and sins, you raised me up, Lord, and opened my eyes to know that there's only one God and that Jesus Christ, your Son, died for me on the cross. And that all I've done before is all God. And that so long as I put my trust in you, that will lead me to eternal life. Father, I'm praying this day, Lord, that all who have heard this message or will hear will also, Father, surrender fully and allow your Son to lead them. And when they do, my Father, I'm praying, may they be empowered, may they be guided, even as you have been guiding me these many years. Father, confirm your words with signs and wonders in their life by visiting them, by guiding them and teaching them those who believe. Deliver them from all evil, O Lord. Preserve them from the evil one, O God. Bless their homes. Bless their work with you. Bless all who are in this ministry. May your countenance continue to shine upon all of us. Even as we wait for your son's return, as you continue to raise your army, Lord, continue to empower them. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name I pray. I will see you all next Sunday by His grace. Please continue to pray for us, just as we pray for you. The times are evil. The times are bad. But Jesus is Lord and is in control. Allow Him to lead you. Praise God.